What is up, internet? Jojo here, and I have another hot take. Now, like last time, this is not a super in-depth analysis like I would normally do, but instead, it's me taking what I know about two characters' powers and skills to come to a conclusion about who I think would win. The topic of today's video is two characters that have green hair, love to punch people, and have butchered their bodies on multiple occasions, and they're both barely teenagers. We're talking about Gon Freecss from Hunter x Hunter and Izuku Midoriya from My Hero Academia. Oh, and by the way, this is going to be filled with spoilers for both franchises, so you have been warned. Because both Gon and Deku have such simple and straightforward abilities, the best place to start would likely be discussing their physical power and making an attempt to see who could punch harder. In a previous video, I calculated that Gon punching this chimera to another country was worth nearly 10 nukes, or about 123 kilotons of TNT. This is quite the impressive feat, as it makes him one of the strongest characters in Hunter x Hunter. However, even that isn't a match for Deku's strength, who is much stronger. You see, back in another video, I calculated the power Deku would need to slam this giant robot as fast as he did. In the end, we get a result of nearly 234 kilotons of TNT. This would firmly put Deku stronger than Gon. Now, to be fair, back when I calculated these feats, both of them, I was using only the manga. If I calculated the same feats at this point in time, I would definitely include the anime, and that would probably make them both yield different results. Maybe more powerful, maybe less powerful, but it actually doesn't matter, as Deku can emulate what All Might could do at 100% of One For All. Now, remember how I said there were going to be massive spoilers? Well, here they are. Deku recently learned how to emulate All Might. He hasn't mastered 100% of One For All yet, but he has the ability to use his other quirks to replicate that level of power. So, because he can scale to All Might, Deku should have access to the same or greater level of power that All Might did when he changed the weather with a punch. This means there's really no question that Deku is more powerful than Gon. In fact, he is potentially in the high gigaton range. Worst of all is that even adult Gon wouldn't stack up according to my calculations, as he would only be capable of generating about 661 megatons of TNT, and that is not something he can spam as much as he wants. He has to be very careful with how he uses it, because the Jojo Ken takes a lot of Nin to use, as Gon's fight with Knuckle showed. Not to mention that to launch his powerful attacks, he has to take a few seconds to charge it, and that would leave him open to getting hit by Deku. On the other hand, Deku can throw his attacks just as fast as All Might. Sure, it is true that Nin works incredibly well on those people who don't have it, but with a power gap this large, I'm not sure it would make that much of a difference. As far as I can see, Gon's only chance of winning would be using his speed, but he would have to be substantially, maybe 5 times faster than Deku, and I don't think he is. This is because Deku, Todoroki, and Bakugo were all keeping up with each other when Deku was around 5% of One For All, and both Todoroki and Bakugo were more than capable of dodging lightning. So if Deku at 5% could match lightning, then at 100%, he should be able to move at nearly 4.4 million miles per hour. This is way more than I calculated for Child Gon's speed, and I did use a lot of feet stacking when I made that calculation. So as far as I can tell, the only way Gon could be faster is if we use adult Gon and assume that Killua, who he scales to, is moving at the speed of the return stroke of a lightning bolt. And with all that I have learned since I made the video about Gon, I have been having my doubts. You know, as a Hunter x Hunter fan, this video is a real downer, isn't it? What? Am I not allowed to have a favorite character? Obviously, I am. So, I'll like who I want to like. Honestly guys, I don't really think Gon has a chance. If the manga had not stopped and had not had such massive hiatuses, I think this would definitely be the other way around, because at least Gon would be doing something, but he has been stagnant for years. Deku, on the other hand, has only been getting stronger, to the point of becoming the world's strongest hero. At this point, not only does Deku have Gon beat in power, stamina, and speed, but he also has several other powers and abilities that Gon can't counter. Deku has acquired a Danger Sense quirk, and that's essentially Spider Sense. With his Black Whip and Float quirk, he has way better maneuverability than Gon, and with his Smoke quirk... Okay, the Smoke quirk is not going to affect Gon that much, as he can counter it with Gyo, but just the Danger Sense quirk alone spikes his chances to win phenomenally, even if he does end up slower than Gon. The other quirks are just icing on a dead Gon. Now, it is definitely true that Gon has more training and actual life and death combat experience, leagues better hand-to-hand training, as well as way better composure in battle, to the point where he will keep fighting even if his arms get blown off. However, these would only have a significant impact if the fight was a lot closer. This is one reason I don't like this matchup. It's not a close fight, it's a stomp. If I was going to put Deku up against anyone, I would put it up against Aang because they have the whole predecessors in their brain thing going on. But on the other hand, Gon's only good opponent is Deku, and if he's not going to fight Deku, then he probably won't fight, well, anyone. Of course, this is just a hot take, and as a Hunter x Hunter fan, I certainly hope I'm wrong, and an in-depth analysis could have many different results. It's not like I hate Deku, because I don't, so my Hero Academia fans, guys, chill, I don't hate Deku. I just really love Gon and don't want to see him die, at least not in a fight that is a stomp. If he's gonna die, at least let it be closer than this. I feel like Gon's best opponent would be some other character who has a similar power type. Perhaps someone from Ruby, Naruto, or Boruto, or some other series with a similar power that runs out, like Ninchakura and Aura. Also, in case you're wondering, right now I am currently watching the Hunter x Hunter anime, albeit very slowly, as I'm watching with a family member, and we only get to watch a few episodes per week. So, I might make another video on Hunter x Hunter eventually, but we'll just have to see. Ever since I started including the anime into my calculations, I have a lot more work to do than if I was just doing the manga. Anyways, thank you guys for watching, see you next time, remember to stay spectacular, JoJo!